Hi guys, Dudley from the Turtle Emporium here. I'm here to talk to you today about Diamondback Terrapins. Diamondback Terrapins, by far my most favourite species of turtle. The word terrapin comes from the Native American word torope, and the only species that really should be called terrapin. The word terrapin is used quite frequently in the UK to describe any freshwater turtles. But really, accurately, they should be called turtles. The only species that should be called terrapin are these guys, because that's what the Americans named them. That's where they're from. It's only right. Their inquisitive nature is utterly fantastic. So friendly, they will happily come to your hand feed. There is a brilliant study that shows that these species form social groups, recognize each other, recognize family members in the wild. In captivity, they can become incredibly tame. They can come to your hand, they can accept fuss, and start to truly recognize you as a member of their own group. But I want to talk to you a little bit about what makes them different and the different subspecies of terrapins that there are. So first of all, let's talk about where are they from. So they're all from North America. They're all from the east coast of North America. And they range from north to south, and we'll discuss that shortly. And there are seven subspecies. Now, there's only one species of Diamondback Terrapin, Malaclemys Terrapin, seven subspecies. There is an argument for there only being five subspecies, but for the moment, scientifically recognized, there are seven. And they are unique in that they live in river estuaries. They're an estuarine species of turtle. So what that means is their habitat is where the river meets the ocean. A lot of people think this means that we need to keep them in brackish water because that's their environment. But in reality, their average environment in the wild is brackish, but they will swim upriver into fresh water, and they will swim out into the ocean into pure saline water. So they actually have a range of salinities that they live in. And believe it or not, they actually need the fresh water to drink. So keeping them brackish causes us problems. It means that we need to provide them with fresh water, which we can do by taking them out once or twice a week, putting them in fresh water for 15 minutes. This gives them enough fresh water to survive on. But for me, the best way of keeping them is in fresh water. That way we don't have to add the salt, we don't have to mess around giving them drinking water. You just need to keep it really, really extra clean compared to other turtles, because diamondbacks, their natural habitat involves the salt, which kills the bacteria on their skin. So they haven't evolved for dirtier water like cooters, sliders, those sorts of things. So for as long as we keep the fresh water really clean, keep that bacteria down, we don't get any problems. So then, let's talk about some Diamondback Terrapins. There are currently seven described subspecies of Malaclemys Terrapin, the Diamondback Terrapin. There is an argument that there should only be five subspecies, but science currently has them as listed as seven, so for now, seven it is. The main defining feature of each species or each subspecies is where they are found to naturally occur in the wild, and normally it's quite obvious from the name. Northern Carolina, Florida East Coast, which is shown as Tequesta on this map, Mississippi, and Texas. The other two subspecies, Ornate and Mangrove, are not quite so obvious. The first subspecies we're going to discuss is one of the two that might be considered the same subspecies, Malaclemys Terrapin Terrapin, or Northern Diamondback Terrapin. This ranges from Cape Cod to Cape Hatteras down the eastern coast of North America, and it lacks the terminal knobs on the central ridge, as seen here. The carapace can range from a dark brown to a tan colour, and you can't really see on this one, but also can have the concentric rings within the carapacial scutes. Some people can't tell this apart at all from the Carolina Diamondback, and this is why they're argued sometimes to be the same subspecies. But the difference is that this one, the carapace, widens towards the back. It diverges posteriorly. And that's the difference between a Carolina and a Northern.
The Northerns do have the same sort of patterning with concentric and speckled that the Carolinas do, but the Carolinas tend to be prettier in that state. The plastron there can be a yellowy to an orange to a grey. The Carolina Diamondback Terrapin, Malaclemys Terrapin centrata. This particular individual is a beautiful concentric with beautiful concentric rings, but it's actually the skin colour that gives them the name concentric. Again, they lack the bulbous knobs on the terminal ridge, but the difference between these and the northern, the marginal scutes flare up slightly, and the shape of it, the edges of the carapace are parallel. But other than that, morphologically so similar to Malaclemys terrapin, that they could be considered the same subspecies. Until science changes it, at the moment, they are two. They do tend to be slightly prettier than the Northerns, but they do both share the ability to have speckled and concentric patterns. This subspecies ranges from Cape Hatteras, south along the coast, to northern Florida. We can see the plastron on this individual is particularly stripy. The next two subspecies of diamondback terrapins are a little more difficult for me to describe, as I don't have them in my collection, so I can't show you any videos of my animals. These images you're about to see have been supplied to me by Jer Cruz, who has kindly donated them to me to use on my website. The first is the Florida East Coast diamondback terrapin, Malaclemys terrapin tequesta. This occurs along the Atlantic coast of Florida. The carapaceal ridge has rear-facing tubercles or knobs. The carapace is dark or tan with no pattern of concentric light circles. The centre of its vertebral and costal scutes may be slightly lighter than the surrounding areas. The mangrove diamondback terrapin, Malaclemys terrapin rhizopharum, is restricted to the Florida Keys and is arguably up there with the ornate diamondback terrapin as being the most striking and most beautiful subspecies. Its carapaceal ridge has terminal bulbous knobs on the vertebral scutes, and its shell is strongly rectangular. The carapaceal scutes have no light centres, and the edges of the marginal and plastral scutes are often highlighted with black. Spots on the neck often fuse to form a streaked pattern, and the hind legs may be striped. Here we have Malaclemys terrapin macrospilota, the ornate diamondback terrapin. As we can see here, the central ridge is getting those terminal knobs here. Carapaceal scutes contain these yellow, sometimes orange centers with darker outer rings. The skin can vary hugely from plain white with no spots to blue, pink, grays, possibly the most beautiful subspecies of diamondback terrapin. Arguably. This subspecies ranges along the Gulf Coast from Florida Bay to the Panhandle. As we go further south, we get to the Mississippi diamondback terrapin, Malaclemys terrapin pileata. As you can see now, the ridges are starting to get more pronounced. Those bulbous knobs at the end there are showing off even more. These individuals are often very dark, almost black, with a yellow tinge to the edge of the marginal scutes, very smoky plastron, grey skin with a darker head and that moustache. Particularly attractive subspecies. This is the second of the other group of diamondback terrapins that might be considered one subspecies. Some people think that these should be combined with the next one I'm about to show you, Malaclemys terrapin litoralis. And finally, we reach the southernmost subspecies of diamondback terrapin found in the United States, Malaclemys terrapin litoralis, the Texas diamondback terrapin. The largest subspecies, marginally larger than any of the others, has these distinct ridges here, the terminal knobs, really showing quite bulbous in this subspecies. The carapaceal scutes are dished in the centre and have a lighter centre than the outside edge, with a brighter yellow marginal scute. Again, these can be found in a variety of colours naturally, from white to grey skin, speckled or concentric. The whiter ones with the darker concentric blotches are often called super Texans. That just refers to their colour. These guys range from the Gulf Coast, south, down to western Louisiana and Texas. Malaclemys terrapin litoralis. Diamondback terrapins come in a massive range of colours naturally in the wild. Here's Freya. She is my adult female, fully grown Carolina diamondback. Very typical coloration, a nice golden carapace there with the concentric rings showing. She's here with, as a nice size comparison, Odin, my male. Again, typical coloration, and you can see the difference there. He's half the size, he's fully grown, thick tail compared to the female. That's the sexual dimorphism of this species showing through there. When we're talking about concentric animals, we're talking about the dark blotches on their skin. So if I bring you down to this end of the tank, here we have Hella. She's a white concentric diamondback. Very white skin, black blotches separately apart. The carapace there, although you can't tell very well in this image, thick concentric rings. And then we have Jord. Jord at the back here is what's known as a blue concentric diamondback. She has that blue-grey skin, real thick blotches, and she's decided to hide now just because I'm filming her. Out we come, and the carapace rings there are really well defined. When she sheds those scutes this season, they'll be truly striking. So here is my growing on tank for my juvenile diamondbacks. I'll show you some other colour variations. This is what we call black velvet. Still Carolina diamondback, still Malaclemys terrapin centrata. Deep black carapace, lacking those patterns, but the skin still white with black, almost like lightning streaks, concentric marks. Still in the show there on the back is Mr. Bojangles, clown concentric, caramel carapace, yellow plastron with black stripes, and round concentric skin marks there. Both beautiful, lovely specimens, both still Carolina diamondbacks. These colours and markings might at first seem an unusual choice, but when you realise, when viewed from above, that the concentric marks on the carapace mimic droplets of water on the water surface, and the colours blend beautiful with the sea floor, you can see why they are this colour. It provides excellent camouflage for the turtles. Even the spots and blotches break up the outline to help protect them from detection by predators.
I hope you've enjoyed this video. If you have, give me a like, give me a subscribe. Any comments, please, below. Let me know what you think or any questions you've got to ask. And I'll keep producing more content for you. Check out my website, www.turtleemporium.co.uk. Thanks for watching.